So the interesting thing about self-care is that 98% of it you already know, and the vast majority of it is free. And it's the things that we know about eating properly, sleeping well, exercising, taking time out for yourself. And these are the things that we don't do. But there are some other things that are actually, that have been shown in the literature and in research to help. And one is mindfulness and mindfulness-based stress reduction. Journaling, writing down our thoughts and feelings can help as well. And just developing our resilience. And in developing our resilience, it's finding meaning in the work that we do and finding the positive things in the work that we do. Because the work we do is actually very satisfying too. And the opposite of compassion fatigue is compassion satisfaction. And that's why we stay in the work, because we at times are, just have amazing, amazing experiences that make us feel very satisfied and give a lot of meaning to what we do. The other problem that the healing professionals have is they are great at looking after others, but they're not so great looking after themselves. And there's a lot of guilt in doing that. So part of what we are trying to educate people on is to give themselves permission to look after themselves. And that, in fact, to look after yourself makes you a better healer, a better nurse, a better doctor, better at whatever you do as a healing professional, if you look after yourself. And sometimes one example I give is, would you want to go see a physician, for example, who is really, really emotionally well and healthy? Or do you want to go see one who's depressed and doesn't really want to talk to you because he's so overwhelmed? And it's clear. Everybody knows what the answer to that is, right? So think of yourself. So that to do your best work and to be the best healer that you can be, you need to be healthy too. So we have to start giving ourselves permission to do that. We can't expect anybody else to help us help ourselves. So that's one of the things that we say. It's not up to your manager or your boss. It's up to you. So you have to decide to do something about this. You have to decide that this is the right thing for you. And in by extension of that, it's the right thing for your patients. And you'll be a much better whatever profession you are in the long run.